Welcome to the Bentley Institute Quick Start Training Course in Modeling Bridge Structures within Iron Bridge Modeling. In this lecture, you will learn how to model a pier segment and how to generate the analytical model. A pier is modeled in a pier segment. Pier segments are located relative to a main girder segment point. They are related to the connection point within the assigned cross section at this segment point. This connection point defines the origin of the virtual vertical axis of the pier segment. As we usually define our pier segments upward, the related stationing will be from minus, in this case 20 meters, up to zero. We continue with the model of the previous lecture. We will introduce a pier in the middle of the main girder. To create a new pier segment, we use the right mouse button on the segment and we select Insert a new segment. Let's call our segment Pier. The type of this segment is not a main girder, but it is a pier. And it is located along our main girder segment. There at segment point in the middle, which is station 50, so segment point 11. And in the cross section, it is connected to the connection point in the middle. Press OK to generate the new segment. Our pier will have a height of 8 meters and it will consist of 4 elements. Therefore, in the upper segment list, we insert new segment points. The stationing will be from minus 8 up to 0 with a step length of 2 meters. And the cross section we use is not the one of the main girder, but our pier cross section. Press OK to generate this structure. Now select the first segment point. Press on Parts and edit the part. We immediately apply a group name, let's call it Pier. We define the material, so we select C3037 and we define the numbering. Let's use element number 1201 and also the same numbering scheme for the nodes. We define it for all the stations along this segment. Press OK to assign this information. In the next step, we have to define the support conditions at the bottom and at the top of this pier. At the bottom, we have soil conditions. Therefore, we will insert a spring zero element. We select the first station. We press on connection. And we insert a new spring. We insert a spring zero. The new element, the new spring element, will have the number 1200. It will be related to the connection point in the middle. And it will have a stiffness in all degree of freedom. Press OK, press OK. And now we define the bearing between the pier and the main girder, which is located at the top of our pier. Therefore, we select the last station of the pier. We insert a new spring. These are a new spring. It will start at segment point 5 of our pier segment, and it will connect this location with the main girder segment, there the segment point 11, and the connection point or the location of the spring is defined in the connection point CPM of the main girder cross section. The number of that spring is 1210. The stiffness is only in vertical direction, so we press on constant. Please remember, by default, springs have a vertical orientation, and therefore the vertical stiffness is Cx. This bearing is free in all other direction and for rotations, and therefore we have to delete all other entries but Cx. Press OK and OK, and our pier segment is finished, so we can have a look on our 3D view. Use the mouse wheel to zoom in and zoom out and have a look on the structure. The last step to generate the analytical model is now to export the modeler information to the solver, Iron Bridge. Therefore, we press on Recalc Modeler. We select Evaluate Formulas, checking the numbering and creating the analytical model. We run this action, and now we can switch to the analyzer. So we double click on analyzer and properties, and we will see that our material data is here available. We have our cross sections, we have the structural nodes, and we have the elements. When we close this table, we will see the structural model as it is exported from the modeler. At the moment, the beam elements are directly located between the nodes. This is because we have not calculated cross-section properties up to now. Once this is done, the beams will be located in the center of gravity of the cross-section. So let's do that. We calculate our structure. We just calculate the cross-section and do a structural check. We press Recalc, and when we zoom in and zoom out, we see that the beam elements are now in the center of gravity of the cross-section. And finally, we can export all the input data to a TCL file, which we use to store the input data and to transfer the model. So we export to a TCL file. Let's call it Quick Start Model and press OK. This will generate two TCL files. You can see them in your directory, and we will use these two TCL files to start the model in the second course of this Iron Bridge Quick Start.